I wasn't able to stay here with my Dutch friend, but we married here in Hampstead and then went to Holland because I could stay with a Dutch citizen, married to a Dutch citizen. After a year in Holland, my wife left me, which was great luck, because had I stayed there, I wouldn't be alive anymore, I'm sure. So I got myself a job in Holland, photographing postcards for newsagents. I was sent to all over the country, made contact with the local newsagent and found out what views they would like photographed. I had a wooden camera given to me by the company who printed these postcards. But after a few months, in the winter, there wasn't anything to do for me. And I tried again to come to England, succeeded to get in as a student in 1935. Here, my sister could help me, put me up in the beginning in her house. I started to photograph children and took portraits and sometimes helped my sister when she had a larger job given to her, like the new block of flats in Kensal Rise, which was built for the gas and light company. For the opening, we made a brochure with photographs of the very modern building. Or there was a hospital, South London Hospital for Women, who wanted a brochure, and I helped her with that. But in 1937, I had the great luck to get an introduction to a documentary filmmaker called Basil Wright, who had a look at photographs I had taken and liked them, but he said, "I have a very small company, only 3 people. I haven't got any work for you. Why don't you go across the road to Paul Rotha, who was a producer at a company called Strand Films in those days?" There was most of the British documentary movement of the 30s